The section 2 of chapter 4, Equation of State, is about Boltzmann equation of state. First, let me introduce the finite strain theory. The finite strain deals with large compression which cannot be approximated by the infinite strain. Among various kinds of finite strain theories, I introduce the Eulerian finite strain theory. There are two features with the Eulerian finite strain theory. One is such that compression is expressed by a state not before but after compression as a reference. In usual case, compression is described using a parameter v over v0. But in the Eulerian finite strain theory, the compression is described by v0 over v. The reason why compression is described using v0 over v is when a volume goes to zero, pressure goes to infinite. This situation is easily expressed using v0 over v as a primary parameter because it goes to infinite when volume goes to zero. The second point is that the discussion starts from changing squared length by compression. Then let me introduce the Eulerian finite strain. Let us consider a cube with a length, edge length of L0 in an unstrained state. Volume V0 is, of course, L0 cubed. Then we compress this cube uniformly to edge length of L. Then volume of the compressed cube is V over V equal L cubed. The shortening or displacement of the edge length, edge is delta L. Therefore, L equals L0 plus delta L. Here, delta L is smaller than zero. Then, change in squared edge length is L0 squared minus L squared, which is equal to L minus delta L squared minus L squared, which is equal to delta L squared minus 2L delta L. Equation 4.2.4. Then, the shortening should be proportional to the edge length. Therefore, delta L can be expressed using CL, and C is a constant. In the usual strain elasticity theory, C is referred to as a strain. The equation 4.2.4 is substituted equation 4.2.5. Then L0 squared minus L squared is equal to delta L squared minus 2L delta L, and which is equal to CL squared minus 2L CL, then which is equal to C squared minus 2C times L squared. Equation 4.2.6. Then we define the Eulerian finite strain as F equal 1 over 2 C squared minus C. Equation 4.2.7. Using this definition, equation 4.2.6 becomes L0 squared minus L squared is equal to 2FL squared. Then let us modify this equation, and we consider the V0 over V here. By these calculations, we have V0 over V 2 over 3 power is equal to 1 plus 2f. Therefore, Eulerian finite strain f is equal to 1 over 2 times v0 over v to 2 over 3 power minus 1. Equation 4.2.8. So the Eulerian finite strain is expressed by volume compression. Then let us introduce second order Bauch-Meinemann equation of state. As we have already discussed in the previous chapter, previous section, pressure is the volume derivative of the Helmholtz free energy F at constant temperature T. Mathematically, the pressure P is equal to minus the partial derivative of the Helmholtz free energy F with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T. Equation 4.1.1. Here, we assume F increases proportionally to the squared finite strain with volume decrease. Thus, the increase of the Helmholtz free energy F is approximately equal to constant A times finite strain squared. Therefore, the volume derivative of the finite strain, the Helmholtz free energy, is expressed by the partial derivative of Helmholtz free energy F with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T is equal to the partial derivative of A times F squared with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T is equal to 2A times the finite strain F times the partial derivative of finite strain F with respect to volume V at constant temperature T. Therefore, the pressure P is equal to minus 2AF times the partial derivative of F with respect to V at constant T. Equation 4.2.10. As we have, we will see later, the A, the parameter constant A is equal to 9 over 2 times KT0, the isothermal bulk modulus, times volume V0. Equation 4.2.11. Then, we have defined the finite Eulerian finite strain F as 1 over 2 times 2 over 3 power of V0 over V minus 1. Therefore, the partial derivative of the finite strain F with respect to volume V at constant T is equal to 1 over 2 times 2 over 3 power of V0 times the partial derivative of volume with respect to volume of volume minus 2 over 3 power of volume at constant temperature T, then which is equal to minus 1 over 3 times 2 over 3 power of volume V0 times minus 5 over 3 power of volume V, which is equal to minus 1 over 3 V0 times 5 over 3 power of V0 over V. Equation 4.2.12. Then we obtain the second order Bauch-Meinemann equation of state. As we have already seen, the pressure P is equal to minus 2 times the constant A times F times round F over round V at T, which is equal to minus 2 times 9 over 2 KT0 V0, the constant A, times the finite strain F, 1 over 2 times 2 over 3 power of V0 over V minus 1, times round F over round V, which is minus 2 over 3 V0 times 5 over 3 power of V0 over V. Then we simplify this equation. We have P equal 3 over 2 times KT0 times 7 over 3 power of V0 over V minus 5 over 3 power of V0 over V. Equation 4.2.13. Let us derive the constant A, which should be equal to 9 over 2 times KT0 times V0. We consider the volume derivative of the finite strain F at pressure equal 0, where V, the volume, is equal to initial volume V0. We have already seen the partial derivative of finite strain F with respect to volume at constant temperature T is equal to minus 1 over 3 V0 times V0, 5 over 3 power of V0 over V. Then, at P pressure equals 0, V equals V0. Therefore, V0 over V equals unity. Therefore, round F over round V at constant temperature T and pressure equals 0 is equal to minus 1 over 3 V0. Next, we consider a volume derivative of pressure at pressure equals 0. The definition of the isothermal bulk modulus KT0 was equal to minus V times the partial derivative of pressure with respect to volume at constant temperature T. From this equation, we have the partial derivative of pressure P with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T is equal to minus KT0 isothermal bulk modulus over V0, V. Therefore, at constant pressure, at pressure 0, round P over round V is equal to minus KT0 over V0. Equation 4.2.15. Then let us come back to the equation to derive the second order Bachmann equation of state, namely P equal minus 2 times constant A times the finite strain F times the partial derivative of the finite strain F with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T. We have a partial derivative of this equation. Then left side is, of course, partial derivative of pressure P with respect to volume V at constant temperature T. Right side is the partial derivative with respect to volume of minus 2a F times round F over round V at T. Then which is equal to minus 2a times the partial round F over round V squared plus F times the second partial derivative of finite strain F with respect to volume V at constant temperature T. Equation 4.2.15. Then at zero pressure, left side is round P over round V at pressure equals 0. Then right side is minus 2a times the finite round F over round V squared. The second term over this in this bracket, a squared bracket, disappear because at pressure equals 0, finite strain F equals 0. And this violet part was equal to minus KT0 over V0, and this blue-green part is minus 1 over 3 V0. Then we simplify this equation, then we obtain A equal 9 over 2 times KT0 V0, equation 4.2.11. Then, next, let us derive the third order Bachmann-Mannoy equation of state. The concept of the third order Bachmann-Mannoy equation of state is almost identical to that of the second order Bachmann-Mannoy equation of state. The difference is change in the Helmholtz free energy is expressed not to the second order but the third order of finite strength. Thus, therefore, the increase of the Helmholtz free energy F by compression is nearly equal to A times F squared plus B times F cubed. Of course, A was constant and B is also constant. Then, as we have already seen, the pressure is equal to the minus the partial derivative of the finite strain F, Helmholtz free energy F, with respect to the volume V at constant temperature T. Then, we consider the partial derivative of Helmholtz free energy with respect to the volume V, which is equal to the partial derivative with respect to volume of A times F squared plus B times F cubed, which is equal to 2AF plus 3BF squared times the partial derivative of finite strain F with respect to volume V at constant temperature T, which is equal to 2AF times 1 plus 3b over 2af times round f over round v at constant t, equation 4.2.18. As shown in the next slide, 3b over 2a is equal to 3 over 2 times kt0 prime minus 4. Kt0 prime is the volume derivative of the isothermal bulk modulus at zero pressure. By substituting equation 4.2.8, 4.2.11, 4.2.12, and 4.2.19 into 4.2.17, we obtain P is equal to minus 2 times 9 over 2 kt0 v0 times 1 over 2 v0 over v to 2 over 3 power minus 1 times 1 plus 3 over 2 times kt0 prime minus 4 times 1 over 2 times 2 over 3 power v0 over v minus 1 times minus 1 over 3v0, 5 over 3 power of v0 over v. By simplifying this equation, pressure P is equal to 3 over 2 times kt0 times 3 over 3 power of v0 over v minus v0 over 5 over 3 power of v0 over v times curly bracket open 1 plus 3 over 4 parenthesis open kt0 prime minus 4 parenthesis close times square bracket open 2 over 3 power of v0 over v minus 1 square bracket close and curly bracket close, equation 4.2.20. So the third order Bachmann-Mannoy equation state becomes identical to second order Bachmann-Mannoy equation of state when kt0 equals 4. When this part becomes 0, then it becomes second order Bachmann-Mannoy equation of state. Here, let me derive the parameter 3b over 2a is equal to 3 over 2 times k prime minus 4. For simplicity, let me define the parameter m is equal to 3b over 2a. Then equation 4.2.18, p equal 2 minus 2af times 1 plus 3b over 2af times round f over round v at t becomes p equal minus 2af 1 plus mf times round f over round v at t. Equation 4.2.21. We differentiate this equation by the volume v. Then the partial derivative of pressure p with respect to volume at t is equal to the partial derivative with respect to volume of minus 2af times round f over round v at t times 1 plus mf. Then it becomes minus 2a times square bracket round f over round v squared plus 2mf times round f over round v squared plus f. The second partial derivative of f with respect to v at t plus mf squared times the partial derivative, second partial derivative of f with respect to the volume v at t. Equation 4.2.22. We differentiate equation 4.2.22 by volume v. Once more again, then second partial derivative of pressure with respect to volume at temperature T is equal to minus 2a times the square bracket blah blah blah, and it becomes this formula. At pressure is zero, namely finite strain F equals zero, then this green term becomes zero. As a result, these terms diminishes. Then the second partial derivative of pressure with respect to volume V at pressure P is equal to minus 2a times 3 times round F round V at pressure P times second derivative of F with respect to V at T and pressure P plus 2m times round F round V at T and p equals 0 cubed. Equation 4.2.24. So let us come back to the derivative of finite strain F. The second partial derivative of finite strain F with respect to volume V at t is equal to 5 over 9v0 squared times 8 over 3 power of V0 over V. At P equals 0, namely V0 over V is equal to unity, the second derivative of finite strain F with respect to volume at T and P equals 0 becomes 5 over 9 V0 squared. Next, let us consider that k prime and second partial derivative volume with respect to pressure. K prime is the partial derivative of isothermal bulk modulus kt with respect to pressure p at t, which is equal to the partial derivative of kt with respect to volume v times the partial derivative of volume with respect to pressure at temperature T. Then, from the definition of the isothermal bulk modulus KT, this first factor becomes the partial derivative of minus V times partial derivative of pressure with respect to volume V, with respect to volume V at T, times minus V over minus v times round f over round v at t. The round p over round v at t comes from a inverse of the second factor, and minus v and minus v in the denominator and numerator, and minus v in the denominator cancels each other. This denominator becomes kt, and therefore this formula becomes v squared times the partial second partial derivative of pressure p with respect to volume v at t minus 1. Therefore, the second partial derivative of pressure with respect to volume v at t is equal to the isothermal bulk modulus kt divided by v squared times kt prime minus plus 1. At pressure 0, this second partial derivative of pressure p with respect to v0 becomes kt0 divided by v0 times kt0 prime plus 1, equation 4.2.26. Then let us substituting equation 4.2.11, a equal 9 over 2 times kt0 v0, 4.2.15, round f over round v at t, p equals 0 is equal to minus 1 over 3 v0. The second partial derivative of finite string f with respect to volume at t and p equals 0 equal 5 over 9 v0 squared. Second partial derivative of pressure with respect to volume v at temperature t and p equals 0 is equal to kt0 over v0 squared kt0 prime plus 1 into the equation 4.2.26, the second partial derivative of pressure P with respect to volume V at T and P equals 0 is equal to minus 2A times square bracket 3 times round F over round V at T and P equals 0 times second partial derivative of the finite string F with respect to volume V at T and P equals 0 plus 2M times round f over round v at t and p equals 0 cubed. Then we have kt0 over v0 squared times kt0 prime plus 1 is equal to minus 2 times 9 over 2 kt0 v0, this a part, and minus 3 times minus 1 over 3v0, this round f over round v part, times 5 over 9v0 squared, this part, plus 2m times minus 1 over 3v cubed. Then we simplify this equation into this one, and we simplifying equation 4.2.27, we have m equal, which is 3b over 2a, is equal to 3 over 2 times kt0 prime minus 4, equation 4.2.19. Finally, let us consider the fourth order Bachmann equation of state. The concept of the fourth-order Bachmann equation state is almost identical to those of that of second and third orders of Bachmann equation state. Only difference is a change in Helmholtz free energy by compression is expanded into the fourth order of finite string f. Thus, the delta f is nearly equal a2 times f squared plus a3 times f cubed times plus a4 times fourth power of f, equation 4.2.28. Then the pressure is minus partial derivative of Helmholtz free energy with respect to volume V at constant temperature, and the this partial derivative of F with respect to V becomes 2AF times 1 plus 3A, 3 times A3 over 2A2 sub 2 F times plus 2A4 over A2 times F squared times round F over round V at T. Equation 4.2.29. The parameter 2A4 over A2 is equal to 9 times KT0 prime squared minus 63 times KT0 prime plus 6 times KT0 times the KT0 double prime plus 143 divided by 6. KT0 double prime is the second pressure derivative of KT0. Equation 4.2.30. In the similar way to the third order Bachmann equation of state, we have a fourth order equation of state as something like this. Let me skip the reading equation. From this slide, I show the proof of 2a sub 4 over a sub 2 is equal to this formula. But the proof is very tedious, therefore let me skip it. Two years ago, I published the derivation of the Bachmann equation of state in this paper. This is English version, and I also published the Japanese version. So I would be happy if you cite these papers if you use Bachmann equation of state in your original paper. Finally, let us see compression behavior of several materials which are used for pressure standard of high pressure experiment. The first example is sodium chloride, NaCl. The bulk modulus and their pressure derivatives are well studied in the case of NaCl. K0 equals 23.7 GPa, K0 prime is 5.14, and K0 double prime is minus 0.392 GPa, inverse GPa. So this red, thin red curve is the second order Bachmann equation state. And this red one is third order Bachmann equation state, and the thick red curve is fourth order Bachmann equation state. The horizontal axis is a V over V0, not V0 over V, and vertical axis is a pressure in GPa. You can see the second order equation of state significantly underestimate the pressure compared to third order and fourth order, because second order and third order become the same when K prime is equal to 4, but K prime is 5.14, which is larger, significantly larger than 4. Therefore, third order equation of state gives higher pressure than second order equation of state. The fourth order equation of state is nearly equal to third order equation of state. Next example is MgO. The K0 equals 160.64 GPa, K0 prime is 4.2, K0 double prime is not determined. Therefore, here we give as a 4. You can see the K0 is much larger over MgO is much larger than NaCl, which was about 20 something. Because K0 prime is slightly larger than 4, the third order equation of state gives a slightly larger pressure than second order equation of state. And when we assume K0 prime equals 0, fourth order equation of state gives higher pressure than third order equation of state. Namely, the third order and the fourth order does not become equal even though the K double prime is assumed 0. And the is gold. K0 is 167.5, which is very similar to MgO. K0 prime is 5.79, which is significantly larger than MgO, whose K0 prime is 4.2. So second order and third order are very different because of the large K0 prime. Third order gives much larger, higher pressure than second order equation of state. And again, even though we assume K0 double prime equals 0, fourth order and third order does not become 0, and fourth order gives a higher pressure than third order. To become these two equation of state identical, K0 prime double prime must be smaller than 0, as is the case in the NaCl. So this is the end of the section 2, Bachmann equation of state, of chapter 4, equation of state.